speaks in a tongue speaks not to men but to God, for no one understands him, but he utters the mysteries in the spirit. On the other hand, the one who prophesies speaks to people for their upbuilding and encouragement and consolation. The one who speaks in a tongue builds up himself, but the one who prophesies builds up the church.
I speak unto thee this day, and I say you are living in a time of great confusion, chaos, and delusion, for I say that men have failed to seek me. That is, men have thought they could run things according to their own understanding, according to their own schemes and dreams, and I say that chaos and confusion and delusion are what they have brought forth. And I say it is me, the living God, who looks at them and all of their folly, their foolishness, and all of their great imaginations. And what do I see? I see men and women who are headed to hell, who are headed to their own damnation. And I say I see others who are hopelessly lost. And I say that I give them the call to repent. And I say, because men are so determined to do it their way, to prove they are right when they are wrong, of course they go headlong into hell. Now I say this day, when you see the pride that is upon nations, that is upon men, that is everywhere throughout the earth, why is it so? I say it is because men have accepted the intoxication of pride. They have imagined they are kings, they are rulers forever, when it is not true. And I say they have superseded me, they do not need me, or so they esteem. But I say they brought forth nothing but confusion and chaos in their lives. And I say that it only grows by the day, for none is true, none is faithful, and none is seeking me. Now I say this day that I, a living God, do intend that men would walk soberly, that they would be in the fear of me, that they would be yielded unto me. But I say, when men have given themselves to a multitude of other lovers, other gods, I say they pay for the same. For I say they have chosen the confusion, the chaos of their own understanding above my way. And I say they have chosen to go on in their own headstrong determination to rule and reign supreme when they absolutely will not remain there. For I say that it is me, the living God, who raises nations up. It is me, the living God, who brings them down. And when men will imagine they remain forever, when they imagine that there will be those who are faithful and loyal unto them, it is not true. For I say that the world is full of bloodshed, the world is full of men who are thirsty for the shedding of blood and for the great power they think they gain from the same. And I say that they bring forth nothing except utter confusion, chaos, disruption, and damnation of soul. For I say, when men have refused to repent, refused to return to me, I say there is nothing that awaits them in the bitter end except the course of their own damnation. Now I say this day that men have grown so proud, so arrogant, so wise in their own conceit, they think somehow they will achieve, they will receive, and they will reign. But I say they are fools who are proving how utterly, ridiculously dumb they are. For I say, when men are trusting in other men, they are trusting in liars and deceivers who are equal unto them themselves. That is, that all men have turned aside to lies, to pride, and contempt for my way. And I say, when men are living in such realms, I say they are living in deception, they are living in destruction and damnation of soul. I say this day that I, a living God, do not call you to be a partaker of their insanity, of their confusion and chaos, but I say that I call you to partake of me. And I say that I call you each day to live with me, to abide in me, that you will know my voice and obey the same. For I say it is only through truly repenting each day and walking soberly and humbly before me that men will be kept. And I say, when men have given way to pride, given way to the shame of the same, I say they are nothing but fools before me. Now I say, when you see men and women in their great power schemes and their dreams whereby they think they remain as kings forever, know that it absolutely is not true. For I say that it is me, the living God, who will see them destroyed, see them brought low, all for another fool to take their place. For I say, when men are refusing to seek my face, to seek my counsel, I say they can do nothing except bring forth more confusion and chaos, destruction and desperation, and I say that they love it so. But I say they are fools who will be taken in the midst of their folly. They are fools who will be destroyed likewise. And I say that they will be damned. But I say, nonetheless, it is me, the living God, who continues to steadily give forth the call to men to repent, to return to me. For I say, if men do not repent, they do nothing except destroy themselves and others likewise. I say this day that I, the living God, am giving to my people the sobering truth that they would walk in me. That is, that they would not be caught up in the hysteria, that they would not be bound in the confusion, the chaos that is ruling throughout this earth. For I say, when I say that I'm giving the call to all men everywhere to repent, no, they are needy of the same. For I say that the nations have estranged themselves from me, they've gone a-whoring, and I say they have turned to be utter fools. I say this day that I, the living God, do not call my people to be in company with fools, but I call my people to walk soberly in me. And I say that I call my people to be thankful that each and every day they can be uplifted, guided, and directed by me. And I say that I call my people to know that through me so are they given the truth, the light, and the mercy day by day. For I say, when a people are trusting, believing, and looking to me, then of course they are guided forth in my way. But I say, when a people have chosen to embroil themselves in the confusion, the chaos, the disruption, the decay, the destruction that is everywhere, then of course they are partakers of the same. I say this day, rejoice that it is me, the living God, you may look to, believe in, and trust day by day. And I say, be thankful that I am the one who will give you newness of life. For I say, if you are coming forth uplifted, directed, and ever guided by me, then I say it is me that you please. But I say, if you are going in the way of the proud, the defiant, the confused fools who think they reign supreme, no, you are headed to the course of destruction. For I say that I, the living God, will give mercy to the ones who truly repent and seek to be restored unto me, but the ones who are wise in their own conceit are headed to destruction. I say this day that I, the living God, will continue to call all men to repent, because yes, they are needy of the same. That is, even the ones who are estranged from me through many generations, I say in the Spirit I give the call. And I say, if men are able to hear me and receive of me, then I say they can be spared by me. That is, they can deeply and thoroughly repent, amend, and change their ways and walk uprightly. I say this day, be thankful for the sobering truth, the clear way of humility that I provide. For I say, when men and women will be accepting my way, they are guided forth by me. And yes, they are given the mercy, the strength, the blessedness, the truth of who I am. For I say that I, the living God, will not, absolutely will not withhold any good thing from those who will choose to walk uprightly in me. That is, the ones who will choose to be partakers of all that I give them time and again. Now I say this day, why not be in union, communion with me day by day? That is, why not be accepting of what it is that I give you and ever walking in the same? For I say, if you are coming forth, ever believing and trusting, hoping in me, then I say you are guided each day. And yes, you are given the blessedness, the truth, the light, and the strength that I provide. For I say it is me, the living God, who is indeed the way of righteousness and truth, the way of mercy and strength and hope provided for any and all who believes upon me. And it is me, the living God, who does ever direct, and instruct the people who are ever thankful to be guided in my way. For I say, when a people are looking to me, believing upon me, and trusting me each day, then they are instructed in life. And yes, they are given the truth and the mercy, the hope and the peace that I provide. But I say, when a people will refuse the call to repentance and literally scoff and mock the same because they are full of themselves, no, they are utter fools. And I say, when the nations have forgotten me, I say they can do nothing except bring more woe to themselves. For I say, when the nations will make their great proclamations, then end in confusion and chaos through it all, what have they gained? I say they've gained nothing except more death, destruction, and damnation of soul. I say this day, do not trust in any nation, do not trust in any men, for I say they are all blowing their own horns. And I say they are trusting that what they say will be, what they do will remain, but it is not true. For I say that time passes on and nations will fall and crumble and be deteriorated from within. And I say that men will follow the wind when they are believing in nations. I say this day there's a way that seems right to men, but I say that way is destruction, for that way is far from me. Now I say this day if men and women would return to me, would seek my counsel, then I say that I would give them my instruction and direction, and I say that they could be removed, come out of the chaos, confusion that is so rampant in the land. But I say when men and women are adhering to confusion, adhering to darkness on every hand, no, they are adhering unto lies. I say this day when I, the living God, do give the call to all men to repent, of course that is what they need. That is to come back to me, to be found abiding in me and be guided in my way. Now I say this day when I, the living God, do offer to the sons of men the way of my truth and my light, I say they are meant to be brought forth each day in me. That is, ever given the blessedness, the truth, and the mercy of who I am, and make glad to partake of me. For I say it is a good thing, a sweet thing, a blessed thing to be ever guided forth by me. That is, to be given the truth and the light, the strength, the mercy, the purpose of who I am. Now I say this day when I, the living God, am giving a call to repentance, revolution, I say obey the same and call others to obey likewise. For I say it is only through true repentance that men are restored to sanity, to sobriety, and to the straight, the narrow way. For I say that you are living in times when men, when nations are drunk and intoxicated on pride. And I say they are going in a way that can only bring death and destruction and damnation of soul. I say this day be thankful that you can indeed be looking unto me as the author and the finisher, the beginning and the end. That you can indeed be partaking of what it is that I give you and ever guided by me. For I say it is a good thing, a sweet thing to be ever living in me, to be partaking of my way. And to be strengthened in the truth, the light, the mercy of who I am, ever rejoicing for the privilege to believe upon me. For I say it is me, the living God, who is the way that is truth and light, the way that is mercy and hope, and the way that is sanity given unto the sons of men. For I say when men will walk humbly before me in repentance each day, then I say they are restored to receive my way. But I say when men will strut and boast themselves in pride, and nations will be far from me because they no longer need me, I say, expect to see nothing but chaos and confusion on every hand. For I say, while men are trusting in their own power plays, they are failing to realize that they themselves are liars dealing with other liars, and all are steeped in lies. And I say, who can they trust? Who can they believe in? Who can they look to? None at all. Therefore, I say, it is nothing that comes forth except chaos, confusion, delusion, and the madness of this age. I say this day be thankful that you do not need to be partakers of all of the insanity, of all of the pride, of all of the stupidity that men are living in. For I say that I do not call you to be proud, to be defiant of me, but I call you to be reliant upon me. That is, ever thankful for the privilege to repent, to declare repentance to a dying world.
As for you, son of man, your people who talk together about you by the walls and at the doors of the houses, say to one another, each to his brother, come and hear what the word is that comes from the Lord. And they come to you as people come, and they sit before you as my people. And they hear what you say, but they will not do it. For with lustful talk in their mouths they act. Their heart is set on their gain. And behold, you are to them like one who sings lustful songs with a beautiful voice and plays well on an instrument. For they hear what you say, but they will not do it. When this comes, and come it will, then they will know that a prophet has been among them.
Attention, please.
Hebrews 9. And just as it is appointed for man to die once, and after that comes judgment.